ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Ollie Joe Prater.
I've been up since 3 o'clock this afternoon. They asked me to make an announcement. There's a brown Pinto parked out front, Alabama license plate. You're not illegally parked, your lights aren't on or nothing, but it's making the club look real shitty. Get out there and move that hunk of shit. I think anybody that owns a Pinto ought to have to marry somebody who owns a Pacer. Why won't anybody buy American cars? Get your hands on a Toyota and you'll never let go. No shit, I had one. I couldn't sell that shit to nobody. It's a planter at my sister's house now. I used to drive an 18-wheeler, boy. Used to love to come up behind them Pintos on the highway real fast. They know they'll explode. You ain't seen shit. You seen a whole family crawl inside a glove box at 60 mile an hour. I'm glad to be here. I haven't been feeling too well lately. Had a touch of that anorexia, you know. Well, I got it whipped now. It was nip and tuck there for a while. Huntsville, Alabama, yeah. The Comedy Club, yeah. I'm glad to be here, man. I'm particularly glad to be here this week, because I was in jail in Nashville last week. Huntsville looking pretty good to my fat ass. You see, I drink. Then I insist on driving. You know, that shit ain't as popular as it used to be. And a while back, I was headed up through Tennessee on Interstate 65 doing 82 and a 55. And all them numbers just fucked me up. And I was shit-faced. I was like one of them puppies in a Puerto Rican's back window. All of a sudden in my rear window, I saw God in the form of a Tennessee State cop. And God was pissed. God's demeanor didn't change much after he got up to my car, because I wouldn't roll my window down. I think if you're God, you can hear me. You know, there's a certain point when you're dealing with the police, you come to the realization, you know, I may not be sleeping in my bed tonight. Cop said, all right, let's see your driver's license, registration, and proof of insurance. Hell, I must have looked for that glove box for 10 minutes until I realized I was sitting in the front seat of his car. Whoops. I felt like Vanna White when nobody gets a letter, you know? Cops said, all right, we're gonna give you the field sobriety test. I said, I don't give a shit. I ain't gonna pass it. I ain't been studying. He said, put your heels together, put your arms out at your side, tip your head back, close your eyes, now with one finger, touch your nose, your nose. It's all right, now say your ABCs. Well, shit. A, B, C, D. Don't sing them. Oh, shit. I'm going to jail. Well, I got to sing them. That's how I learned a goddamn thing. Try to say them, get up around Q and R, and the shit falls apart on me. Well, it took me in. You know, it's the dumbest thing. You're so goddamn drunk you can't grab your ass with both hands. They get you in there and say, all right, I want you to blow on this breathalyzer. I figure, shit, I'm already in jail. Why don't you blow on my breathalyzer? They didn't think it was quite that funny. Make a long story short, I blew on their breathalyzer. And the readout came, said, one at a time, please.